Hello, friend. Welcome to Android Chess, written in Kotlin program language. This is Golden Thumb. So here we are. Chess, written in Kotlin for Android. Okay, so now let's bring up our Android Studio application, Android Studio, and Chess. Okay.Permission denied. Can we do that? Android Studio. That's interesting. Android didn't permission.Yeah, I don't know why, but anyway, we can bring up in this way. So here is our, okay, in this video, we'll fix one issue. Let's bring up our emulator first, this guy. Okay, run it.So remember, we have three buttons, right? Reset, listen for the server socket, and connect when we play the role as client socket. So when we click the listen button in the middle, we bring up our server socket, right? Listening on port, this guy, right? This port.What if we press the button again? Let's see. What if we bring up our, so this is build run, okay. So clear.Let's clear again. So now let's go to the app and listen. Socket server listening on port. Oh, it's okay. Yeah, this is the guest port, okay? Now if we click again, crash, right? What is the problem?Address already in use, right? Yeah, you cannot create another server socket listening on the same port. Okay, let's fix it. So we want to disable it, right? Disable the button so we cannot click again. And let's do it. So three buttons. So we use this to find out the button, and there's a better way to organize our buttons. We can use late init. It's called lazy initialization. Okay, so it means we promised we'll initialize that sometime. So private late init var, and the first button is reset button. Okay, reset button. The data type is button, this guy, and private late init listen button, right, for our server socket button, the last one, and connect button. This is our, when we use the app as the client socket. Okay, now we can do, yeah, put it here, right? So reset button, reset button equals, this is our reset button, right? Cut, put here. And what's the next one? listen button, right? Equals listen button is this guy. Cut. Put it here. Now connect button equals this guy here. Why do we need that? Because we'll use those variables, right? Those variables are multiple times. So for example, here is our reset button. Set click listener like that. Okay, so here is our listen button. Here is our connect button. Okay, now after we click this button, we want to disable it, right? Yeah, let's disable it here. Listen button dot is enabled equals false. Okay. Let's give it a try. Run it. Actually, we don't need this because hopefully when we click the button, it will be disabled. Yeah, there's no way to click it again, right? And yeah, but we still want to, after we click reset, right? We'd better to enable this one, and ideally we can reset all the state, right? All the states in this app, so we can make this server circuit listen again, and we'll do that in our next video. Okay, reset, so we can enable this one and enable we'll reset the, we'll close the socket, server socket, and then we can re-listen. Yeah, and let's make a commit here. Yeah, we modify that. So disable, what is the listen button, okay? Button listen after disable button listen after being being pressed. Okay, push. So yeah, you can check out the latest code here in our GitHub repository. Thank you for watching. See you next time.